And the Prophet ﷺ this time looked at Jibreel alayhi salam when they reached Sidrat al-Muntaha and once again sees him in his full form. This time he sees him from top to bottom. The first time he saw him, bottom to top, right? In his full form. The Prophet ﷺ said that Sidrat al-Muntaha, describing it, he said the colors of that tree were indescribable, right? Now, here in Dallas, mashallah, we have a lot of places to scuba dive and snorkel, so we've seen the bottom of the ocean, right? Right? No, okay? If you've ever been to the bottom of the ocean and you've seen the colors at the bottom of the ocean, are those colors describable? Are they? Not really, right? They're amazing. They're things that you've never seen before. Imagine Sidrat al-Muntaha. The Prophet ﷺ said, look, I can't describe to you the colors of that tree. But as the Prophet ﷺ continued to go forward and he reached Sidrat al-Muntaha now and they were walking through, he said, نَظَرْتُ إِلَىٰ Jibril. So I looked at Jibril. Why? The entire journey goes like this. Jibril, what's that? مَا هَذَا يَا Jibril. مَا هَذَا يَا Jibril. What's that? What's that? Who is that, يَا Jibril? He said, but this time, نَظَرْتُ إِلَىٰ Jibril فَإِذَا هُوَ كَالْحِرْسِ الْبَالِ مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ. He said, Jibril was like a flattened rug out of his awe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was looking up and he was flattened. Meaning, subhanAllah, he was in complete awe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, knowing the closeness that he had to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at that point of Sidrat al-Muntaha. And the Prophet ﷺ entered and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke to him directly, the same way he spoke to Musa alayhi salam, to Moses, peace be upon him, and he gave him the same order that he gave to Musa alayhi salam to establish the prayer. And the Prophet ﷺ on his way down, and obviously I'm skipping some of the details of al-Isra' wal-Mi'raj because of time, on his way down, the Prophet ﷺ said one more sight that he saw. Rasulullah ﷺ said, Ra'aytul umam. Suddenly I saw nations of people. They were standing behind their prophets. Each prophet had one or two or three or four or 100 or whatever it is, had someone behind him, right? And he said there were actually some prophets that had no one behind them at all. I just saw all of these nations, all of these prophets with their nations behind them. He said, then suddenly I saw this huge nation. Now realize the Prophet ﷺ, at this point of his life, he has a very small amount of followers. It's not that many followers, right? This is before Medina, before the Hijrah. You're talking about, 100 something followers. And the Prophet ﷺ said, I saw this huge nation. And I asked Jibreel, I said, Jibreel, is that mine? Jibreel said, no. I said, Jibreel took me and he turned me around. And he said, I saw a nation that was far bigger than that one. It dwarfed that nation. And Jibreel said, هَاُولَىٰ أُمَّتُكَ. That's your ummah. SubhanAllah, can you imagine if we were standing there that day when Jibreel showed the Prophet ﷺ billions of people and said, that's your ummah. Those are the amount of people that you are going to have that are going to follow you. The Prophet ﷺ said, then we returned. And SubhanAllah, the next day Jibreel came to the Prophet ﷺ, this time in his human form. And he came to Rasulullah ﷺ at the time of Dhuhr. The command of prayer has been given to him. So he came to him at the time of Dhuhr. And the Prophet ﷺ said, فَأَمَّنِي فَصَلَّيْتُ مَعَهُ. He led me in prayer and I prayed behind him. And he came to me at Asr and did the same thing. Maghrib, Isha and Fajr and did the same thing. Then he came the next day at the end of those times and led me again. And then told me that the salah is between these two, that your window of time is between these two prayers. Each salah is to be prayed between those two timings that we prayed together. And subhanAllah, it was common knowledge amongst the companions actually. This is an interesting historical fact without going too far into it, that some of the companions thought the Prophet ﷺ led Jibreel in salah. And it became a point of contention. And Umar ibn Abdul Aziz settled this debate in his home as the Khalifa, because Urwa ibn Zubayr was the one narrating all the ahadith. He said, اعلم ما تقول يا عروة. You better be sure of what you're saying, O Urwa. And Urwa went through all of the different chains of narration where the Prophet ﷺ said, جاءني فأمني. He came to me and he led me in salah. فصليت معه. The same way that Jibreel came and showed the Prophet ﷺ Hajj and he did Hajj with him, he came to the Prophet ﷺ and he taught him the salah step by step, each and every single step of the prayer. And subhanAllah, the prayer would develop gradually over time, obviously, right? When the Prophet ﷺ was praying towards Al-Aqsa for 18 months or so. And then they were switched towards Mecca. And Jibreel alayhi salam, he came to the Prophet ﷺ, and the Prophet ﷺ, he said, what happened to all the other, what happened to all the other prayers though? And Allah revealed what? وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُضِيعَ إِيمَانَكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to let your faith go to waste, your prayers go to waste. Now as a final note here before we break for Maghrib, just something very interesting here, very, very cool that you might not have thought of. Do you ever mention Jibreel in your salah? Do you mention Jibreel in your salah? All right, let's go through the different ways that you could possibly mention Jibreel in your salah. When the Prophet ﷺ would start his prayer, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she was asked, how did the Prophet ﷺ used to start his prayer? And she said that one of the things that he used to say, especially in his tahajjud, the Prophet ﷺ would say, Allahumma rabba Jibreel wa Mika'il wa Israfil, Fatir al-Samawati wal-Ard, Alim al-Ghaybi wa-Shahada, until the end of the dua. It's a long dua. You can find it in Fortress of the Muslim. In fact, if you go to Google and you search Lord of Jibreel, Mikael, and Israfil, you're only going to get two du'as. All right, so just search it, okay? So the Prophet ﷺ would make a du'a in the beginning of his salah, mentioning the Lord of Jibreel, Mikael, and Israfil. How about in ruku' and in sujood, bowing and prostrating? This is interesting because we're about to go to salah right now, so I want you guys to try to remember this. Do you mention Jibreel? In fact, the Prophet ﷺ mentioned Jibreel in every single ruku' and in every single sujood. Subuh. Quddus, Rabbul Malaikati, Warruh. So you glorify Allah, the Lord of the angels, and specifically Arruh, Jibreel alayhi salam. And Aisha says the Prophet ﷺ never did ruku' or sujood except that he said it. Some of the scholars even considered it wajib. Alright, it's a minor opinion, but that's how often the Prophet ﷺ used to say it. Some consider it even mandatory. What about in your tashahud? So we've covered starting the salah, ruku', sujood. What about in your tashahud when you're sitting down? Listen to this hadith. Abu Salama radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he says that the Prophet ﷺ, when he saw us after we were taught the prayer, he said we used to say in our tashahud when we sat down, As-salamu ala Allah, As-salamu ala Jibreel, As-salamu ala Mika'il. As-salamu ala Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So they would send salam on Allah, Jibreel, Mikael, and then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alright? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to us and he said, as for Allah, huwa as-salam. Allah is as-salam. So instead say, at-tahiyyatu lillah wa salawatu wa tayyibat. There's some people that think that this was a conversation. There is actually no authentic narration about this being a conversation. It may have been or may not have been, but it's not really established in any hadith whatsoever. The Prophet ﷺ said, look, instead say, At-tahiyyatu lillah. Greet Allah with your prayers, with your good deeds, and greet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in other ways. You can't say, As-salamu ala Allah. And you can say, As-salamu alayka ayyuhal nabi. So you send salam on the Prophet ﷺ, wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, As-salamu alayna wa ala ibadillah as-salihin. Peace be unto us and on the righteous servants of Allah. You know what's amazing? The Prophet ﷺ said, when you say, ibadillah as-salihin, the righteous servants of Allah, it will reach Jibreel, it will reach Mika'il, it will reach all of the inhabitants of the heavens and all of the inhabitants of the earth who are righteous servants of Allah. So when you say, ala ibadillah as-salihin, you're actually making dua for Jibreel as well. You're sending salam on Jibreel as well. Finally, when you finish your prayer, Aisha radiallahu anha says, and this is the second of the two du'as that the Prophet ﷺ used to say, Rabba Jibreel, the Prophet ﷺ would say, Allahumma Rabba Jibreel wa Mika'il wa Israfil, a'idhni min harri nar wa azab al-qabr. Protect me from the punishment of hellfire and the heat of hellfire and the punishment of the grave. So there is actually a mention of Jibreel alayhi salam in every part of our salah.